Hello, I'm Julian Baggini, and welcome to another in this series of films in which I'm bringing philosophy into your kitchen and to your table. Now, today I'm going to be making a kind of focaccia bread, but what makes it really special is that it's going to be made with an ancient kind of wheat called Einkorn. And understanding why that's significant and important is going to also shed light on some broader philosophical truths. So here's what you're going to need. 500 grams of sieved Einkorn flour, teaspoon of quick yeast, teaspoon of salt, and some extra virgin olive oil, also about 310 milliliters of warm water. Probably made that dough a bit too sticky, so I'm being even more generous with the dusting than usual, because I'd quite like it to absorb some of that flour as I knead it. So, I mean, you know, part of the point I'm trying to make really with this series is that, you know, you don't need professional level techniques and skills in order to, you know, cook really well at home. You can still make damn good stuff. Even if those of you who know more about bread baking than me will look at the way I'm kneading this bread and think, that's terrible. You need about 5 or 10 minutes of this kneading, and I'm working in quite a bit more flour because by the feel of the dough, I think I added a bit too much liquid in the beginning, so it could do with absorbing a bit more flour. Now, if you've seen another film in this series, you may have heard me talking about how, you know, you should rip up recipes and everything, and you may think, well, that's all very well, but, you know, in this case, I am following a recipe. There are weights and measures here. Am I being inconsistent? Well, the answer is no, because actually, if you think about it, the point about avoiding recipes or not relying on them is that, you know, there isn't a one size fits all rule for every occasion. You have to exercise discretion. And it'd be totally against the spirit of that whole point to say that there is never, ever a right time to use recipes. When it comes to baking, you do generally need to weigh things out and measure things and follow. But actually, even then, it's surprising how often there's quite a lot of room for flexibility and improvisation. And you have to be able to do a bit of that in order to make sure that you can adapt to circumstances. So, for example, if your dough is too wet or too dry, you adjust accordingly. As I said, Einkorn, the wheat here, is a very, very ancient form of wheat. It's been regrown in Britain now by Dove's Farm. It has very, very few heads of, you know, wheat per stalk. It's very vulnerable. It's not very efficient. The husks are very tough. It takes really hard work to sort of de-hull it. So the question you might ask, why on earth would you bother trying to revive this wheat when it appears that modern varieties do the job a lot better and more efficiently? Part of the answers are just pragmatic, actually. We've become very reliant in modern agriculture on these kind of breeds, which are all very well and very efficient, but they're used everywhere, almost universally. And we're very vulnerable. If some pest comes along or disease which destroys it, then, you know, we could be left with nothing else. So we actually need to maintain other varieties, even if they're not the most viable at the moment, because we may need in the future to sort of crossbreed with them or go back to them if our current ones fail. But practical prudence isn't the only reason for preserving old food ways and old foodstuffs. I think we have a duty of stewardship to take what is good in what we now have and to pass it on in good condition to future generations. That isn't about slavishly conserving everything, of course. You have to use judgment, but it is about recognizing what is of good and what is of value and being able to maintain that so that others in the future are able to enjoy it as well. Okay, so it's time to stretch the dough for this bread. I don't have a really good receptacle for this, so I'm just using a Pyrex disc lined with paper. as you can see, very, very rough and ready, this. But you know, this is a rustic style bread, so we don't have to worry about it being completely pretty. That's looking good. Just going to give that another perhaps 30 minutes to rise, although to be honest, I left it a little bit long beforehand, so I might give it less. I'm in a hurry, I'm hungry. Okay, so final bit with this focaccia-ish bread. It's ready to go. I'll just make some dimples with my finger, like this. It's nice and uneven, which I kind of like. I'm going to put some sprigs of rosemary around it. I'm going to sprinkle some coarse sea salt over the top. And I'm going to be fairly generous with some olive oil. Now that's going to go in for 10 minutes at about 250 degrees. After 10 minutes, I'll turn it down to about 200, and hopefully that'll be lovely. Now, there is, of course, another even simpler reason why we ought to preserve foods like einkorn. I'm no baker, but with flour as good as this, even I can make really tasty bread. We'll hear it beeping, and that'll be a bit of a drama. Drama, it's the wrong word, isn't it?